Wes Anderson, American auteur. Loved by both cinematic academics and stoner art house hippies alike, he was born and raised in Houston, Texas, and he dealt with the separation of his parents, which drove him to misbehave in school. But this mischief later metamorphosized into creative passion, which brought him to where he is today. He has seemingly bridged the gap between consumer cinema and surreal, stylized film. The most substantial testament to this is his use of mise-en-scene. When you watch a Wes Anderson film, you know you're watching a Wes Anderson film. His unique sense of symmetry and storybook-like sets throw you into a heightened reality that he utilizes to tell strong, dramatic stories. Take, for example, Moonrise Kingdom. He's tackling some extremely heavy mythology. The journey from boyhood to manhood, the separation of child and parent to achieve enlightenment, toxic models of manhood, child abandonment, and the list goes on. But take a look at the way he does it. He doesn't tackle these heavy themes with dark, R-rated imagery, but rather elementary, theatrical imagery that holds the hand of the audience as they digest those heavier themes. Another example is his masterpiece, Rushmore, a film about the cultural standards of love and the taboo of demolishing those standards. It is yet another tale of boyhood to manhood, but again, look at how he approaches it. There's nothing unsettling, nothing hard-hitting, just symmetry and elaborate sets that get the job done. And the same can be said about his piece, Grand Budapest Hotel. When was the last time you saw a film covering the ill effects of the Second World War in a way that appeared like this? Or like this? Ironically, it's this approach to adult themes from an almost childlike perspective that offers the most perspective on these heavier themes. He adds some flavor to the medicine we have to swallow, and by that, we are much more receptive to the realities of what Wes Anderson has to say.